Hello friends, the fifth generation 5G mobile network is on the horizon and promises to deliver connectivity fabric that will take on much larger role than the previous generations. So today we are going to present you a presentation on 5G network. Let us start. What is 5G? Let us first answer this. 5G is the next generation of cellular mobile communications. It succeeds the 4G, LTE, WiMAX, 3G, UMTS and 2G GSM systems. 5G performance targets high data rate, reduced latency, energy saving, cost reduction, higher system capacity and massive device connectivity. The first phase of 5G specification in release 15 will be completed by April 2019 to accommodate the early commercial deployment. And the second phase in release 16 is due to be completed by April 2020 for submission to the International Telecommunications Union, ITU, as a candidate of IMT 2020 technology. It is a new kind of network that will not only interconnect people, but also interconnect and control machines, objects and devices. A platform for innovations that can enable new services, empower new user experiences and connect new industries. 5G will significantly enhance and lower cost of mobile broadband services available today on 3G and 4G networks, while also bringing new kinds of services to life, such as enabling mission critical control through ultra reliable low latency links and connecting the massive Internet of Things. Making this 5G vision a reality will require a unified, more capable air interface design that will bring new levels of flexibility, scalability and efficiency to meet the expanding connectivity needs in the next decade and beyond. Let us move on to the 5G standards. The official name of 5G is NR, that stands for New Radio. There are three key stakeholders for the 5G. The first, International Telecommunications Union, ITU. The final standard will be International Mobile Telecommunications, IMT 2020. Then the second is the 3GPP, is the Mobile Industry Standards. It will submit the proposal specifications to the ITU to be part of IMT 2020 standard. Then the third stakeholders are mobile operators and vendors. They will participate in the 3GPP specification process for realizing interoperability between multiple vendors. 5G standards have not yet defined 5G requirements, but various groups are analyzing the possibility of what might constitute 5G for network deployments in 2020 or beyond. Regarding that, ITU, IMT 2020 has defined technical requirements for 5G and 3GPP is developing the specifications. Now let us see the formal definition of NR or New Radio. NR is a collection of technology from physical layers to core network that need to achieve the following three major features requirement as illustrated below. The terms shown in the next diagram are also formal 3GPP terms, and you will see these terms in most of the 3GPP documents on NR. So it will be good for you to get familiar with these terminologies. If you look at the diagram, you will see the three terms. First is enhanced mobile broadband. The second is massive machine type communications. And the third term is ultra reliable low latency communications. These are the use cases for 5G. As you can see, the enhanced mobile broadband, it will need low latency and higher spectral efficiency or throughput. Then the massive machine type communications, it will need improved link budget, low device complexity, long device battery life and high density device deployment. And the third, ultra reliable low latency communication, this will need high reliability and low latency. Then let us see the 5G use cases in details. Enhanced mobile broadband. These use cases generally will have requirements of higher data rates and better coverage. You can see in the next figure, improved consumer experience, more connected devices, faster connection speed, virtual and augmented reality. So all these applications can be done here with the help of enhanced mobile broadband. So the speed or data requirement will be high. Second is ultra reliable and low latency communications. Here the examples are vehicle to everything communication, drone delivery, then autonomous monitoring, smart manufacturing. So they will again have strict requirements on latency and reliability and are used for mission critical applications. Then the third is massive machine type communications, MMTC. These are use cases generally have requirements to support a very large number of devices in a small area, therefore very large device density. Then typical applications fall under IoT based deployments. E-health, transport and logistics, environmental monitoring, smart energy networks, smart agriculture, small retail, etc. These are the types of applications which will fall under this category. Let's see some more examples of use cases. First is broadband access in dense areas. This family highlights the broad range of growing and new use cases of the fully connected society. The focus is service availability in densely populated areas. For example, multi-story building, dense urban city centers or events where thousands of people per square kilometer live or work. Communications are expected to be pervasive and part of everyday life. Augmented reality, multi-user interaction, three-dimensional services will be among the services which will play an increasingly significant role in 2020 plus time frame. Context recognition will be an essential aspect at the network edge, ensuring delivery of consistent and personalized services to the customers. This family includes use cases such as pervasive video, smart office, operator cloud services, and HD video or photo sharing in stadium or open air gathering. And the next use case is broadband access everywhere. This family highlights the need to provide access to broadband service everywhere, including the more challenging situation in terms of coverage from urban to suburban and rural areas. A consistent user experience with respect to throughput needs a minimum data rate guaranteed everywhere. Further development of digital inclusion of people living in scarcely populated areas and in developing countries requires the infrastructure deployment cost to be a key factor in services. This family includes the use cases 50 plus Mbps everywhere and ultra low cost networks. Third use case is higher user mobility. Beyond 2020, there will be a growing demand for mobile services in vehicles, trains, and even aircrafts. While some services are the natural evolution of existing one, navigation, entertainment, etc., some other represent completely new scenarios such as broadband communication services on commercial aircrafts by a hub or board. Then vehicles will demand enhanced connectivity for in-vehicle entertainment, accessing the internet, enhanced navigation through instant and real-time information, autonomous driving, safety and vehicle diagnostic. The degree of mobility required will depend on the specific use cases. This family includes high-speed train, remote computing, moving hotspots, 3D connectivity, that is aircrafts, etc. The next use case is massive Internet of Things, IoT. The vision of 2020 and beyond also includes a great deal of growing use cases with massive number of devices. Example, sensors, actuators, cameras with a wide range of characteristics and demands. This family will include both low cost, low range, low power MTC as well as broadband MTC with some characteristics closer to human type communication. This family includes the following cases: smart wearables, that is clothes, then sensor networks, mobile video surveillance. Next family is extreme real-time communications. This family covers use cases which have strong demand in terms of real-time interaction. These demands are use case specific and, for instance, may require one or more attributes such as extremely high throughput, mobility, critical reliability, etc. For example, the autonomous driving use case that requires ultra reliable communication may also require immediate reaction based on real-time interaction to prevent road accidents. Other such as remote computing with stringent latency requirement may need robust communication link with high availability. This family includes the case tactile internet. Tactile interaction is referred to as a system where humans will wirelessly control real and virtual objects. Then the next use case is lifeline communication. Public safety and emergency services that are provided today are continuously improving. In addition to new capabilities for authority to citizen and citizen to authority communication for alerting and support, these cases will evolve to include emerging and new applications for authority to authority communication, emergency prediction and disaster relief. So this will include natural disaster. Then the next use case is ultra reliable communication. The vision of 2020 and beyond suggests that only significant growth in such areas as automotive, health and assisted living applications, but a new world in which the industries from manufacturing to agriculture rely on reliable machine type communication. This family will include applications such as automated traffic control and driving, collaborative robots, a control network for robots, e-health, extreme life critical, object manipulation and remote surgery, 3D connectivity, that is drones. Here, for example, a delivery of medicine to address with drones automatically finding the way using remote control system that exploits a 5G communication. Then the last service is broadcast-like services. While personalization of communication will lead to a reducing demand for legacy broadcast as deployed today, example linear TV, the fully mobile and connected society will nonetheless need efficient distribution of information from one source to many destinations. These services may distribute content as done today, typically only downlink, but also provide feedback channel uplink for interactive services as acknowledgement information. Both real-time or non-real-time services should be possible. Include news and information, local broadcast-like services, then regional broadcast-like services, etc. Now let us move on to the 5G requirements and performance targets. As you can see in the figure, there are five requirements shown. First is high data rates. So 10 to 100 times increase in even in high mobility. That is the requirement. Then second requirement is high system capacity. 1000 times improvement should be there in the capacity. Then reduce latency. Latency should be less than 1 millisecond end to end. Then energy saving and cost reduction, network and terminals including backhaul. And then massive device connectivity, 100 times improvement even in crowded areas. So these are the general requirements in terms of performance for the 5G network. Let us see the key capabilities. Now first capability is peak data rate. The maximum achievable data rate 5G target is 20 gigabits per second. Then the second is user experience data rate. It may, that is the achievable data rate across the coverage area, that may go up to 1 gigabit per second. Then latency, radio network contribution to packet travel time, that should be 1 milliseconds. So here ultra reliable services will take use of that. Then the next is mobility. Maximum speed for handoff and QoS requirements, that is targeted as 500 kilometers per hour. So here again EMBB and URLLC. These two are the usage scenarios. Then next is connection density. Total number of devices per unit area. It is targeted as 1 lakhs per square kilometer. So the main usage scenario will be MMTC. Then energy efficiency. The data sent or received per unit energy consumption by device or network, that should be equal to 4G. Then spectrum efficiency. Throughput per unit wireless bandwidth and per network cell, it should be 3 to 4 times 4G. And the area traffic capacity, total traffic across coverage, it should be 1000 Mbits per meter square. These are the key capabilities. As you can see in the figure, it is shown in comparison with the 4G network or advanced IMT. Let's see the spectrum for 5G. As you can see in the figure, it ranges from sub gigahertz to mm wave, that is micrometer wave. Here the low frequencies will be used for full area coverage, and the higher frequencies will be used for extreme traffic capacity and data rates in dense scenarios. So 5G NR is being designed to get most out of every bit of spectrum across a wide array of spectrum regulatory paradigms, including licensed, shared and unlicensed, and all spectrum bands from low bands below 1 GHz to mid bands 1 to 6 GHz and to high bands known as millimeter wave, that is mm wave. So 5G NR will support wide range of deployment models, from traditional macro to hotspot deployments, as well as new ways to interconnect devices, such as device to device and multi-hop mesh, that will open doors to more opportunities and broaden the mobile ecosystem. Then let us come to the references. Here I have mentioned the references for those who want to go into the details of the topic. First is Wikipedia, then second is Netmanias, and then ShareTechNote, and next are the some of the 5G white papers, NGMN Alliance white paper and ITU IMT Vision white paper. So they can visit the websites and get the in-depth knowledge. Thank you. This was our first video on the series Latest Technologies. If you have some takeaway, please like, share and subscribe our channel Engineering and Technology for You. Thank you.